we propose new areas, like, for instance, the area of refinery and exploration of for petroleum products. We've got some little oil which we want to export as crude, but also refine for the East African market.
While speaking at the Russia-Africa summit, President Museveni also proposed to his host, President Putin, to discourage by policy the importation of raw materials from Africa, but instead work with the African governments to add value to products as source, as this would transform the economies of the continent in a very short time from low middle income to high middle income status.
With the Russian groups on building a nuclear power station for generating electricity. And that one is going on, and I'm very happy with that. Then we have fertilizers, very big potential for phosphates and for potassium, and also for ammonia. And I would want to invite Russian companies to if they can, to take part in that.
President Museveni hailed Uganda-Russia military cooperation, which he said has helped his country to become an island of peace in our part of the world. He said this was made possible through procurement of equipment from Russia over the years.
The formation of the African National Congress in South Africa in 1912. That was the first time the Africans were organizing for liberating Africa. Then in 1917, the communists took over power in Russia here, and they were the first international group to support us. And then later on, they were joined by China, 1949. That formed a solid anti-colonial force. So even when all these things are happening, we tell whoever wants that, look here, the Soviet people are the first who stood with us when we were fighting against colonialism.
However, President Putin, on his part, said that Uganda remains one of Russia's key partners and allies on the African continent, with the diplomatic relationship that stretched over 60 years, and committed to strengthening cooperation between Russia and Africa in economic, political, security, trade, and humanitarian areas.
Прошлый раз мы виделись с вами в Сочи в ходе первого саммита Россия-Африка. И я признателен вам за то, что вы прибыли сегодня в Петербург во главе делегации Уганды и участвуете во втором нашем саммите.
President Putin further said that he was happy that Uganda and Russia have close positions on the international arena that he said is based on commitment to shaping a just world that is accommodative to everyone, and expressed happiness that Uganda was to chair the non-allied movement. Meanwhile, the two-day Russia-Africa summit that kicked off yesterday is the highest profile and largest scale event in Russian-African relations, aimed at bringing about a fundamentally new level of mutually beneficial partnership to meet the challenges of the 21st century. The goal of the event is to promote efforts to strengthen comprehensive and equal cooperation between Russia and African nations across all areas of society, including politics, security, economic relations, science and technology, and the cultural and humanitarian spheres.